a love for nature that I have, and I try to put that kind of feeling into my music. So, you know, I would like for people to be able to kind of have that same experience when they listen to my music, even if they're sitting in an office building in a city, which, you know, hopefully they can visualize in their mind what I'm trying to get across in my music. 안녕하세요, 여러분. 다시 만났어요. 반갑습니다. 행복한 시간 되세요. 감사합니다. I just like to thank you so much for coming out tonight, and I'd like to thank EBS Space Gangnam for inviting me here today. We had a concert last night and another one today. It's a great place and a great audience so far. So I'm very excited. The last two songs were Sunrise and Moonrise. And a lot of people ask me why my songs have nature titles. I live in Idaho. I live in the trees and, you know, by lakes. And I really, when I write music, I am trying to, you know, kind of give people peace. You know, I'm trying to give them a bit of that nature that I am able to enjoy. So I write music in that way, and then I title them so that you can have that same feeling. Jay Chingu cellist David Hunt, 소개합니다. 데이비드 is going to play a little song that I wrote for him specifically for this moment. It's called Tuning. The next song that we're going to perform is called A Walk in the Forest, and I would love it all if you could all while we're playing just to imagine yourselves walking in a big redwood forest, and, you know, nice warm day, and maybe a little mist on the horizon. Thank you. Do I agree with that? Yeah, I'm very, very appreciative of that they feel that way. That is an incredible honor. Whenever I write a song or release an album, I'm trying to do the best I possibly can. I'm trying to make the best album for myself and for my listeners. And sometimes it works, and sometimes it doesn't work as well. But to be appreciated for what, you know, my life's work is pretty neat. Originally, my music was classified as new age, and I haven't always my music doesn't really fit into new age. I mean, it's more contemporary classical kind of new age. It's kind of, you know, new age music to me early on was synthesizers and, you know, just kind of washing music, and my stuff's a little bit more classical in feel. Although, you know, if you in America, if you go into the record store, there's classical music, which is Mozart and Beethoven, and then there's new age music, which is everybody who, you know, plays a piano that writes their own songs. So we kind of got categorized as new age music if you're not Mozart. So, you know, I'm fine with it, with the title, but to me it's more just contemporary instrumental piano music. Thank you. Kabasmida. Thank you. That last song was called Song for Rome. And the next song we're going to do is called Song for Siena. And those are my two daughters. Jamie Rome is my oldest daughter. She's 12. And Reagan Siena is my youngest daughter. She's 10. When my wife and I were first married, we went to Italy. And Jamie Rome was conceived in Rome. So that's where she got her name. And then Reagan's name is just, we just loved the name of that city. When I wrote Song for Siena in 2004, and my youngest daughter was very happy with me for writing her a song. You know, it's a cool thing. And it took me 4 years to write a song for Jamie Rome, and she was very, very angry with me. So I finally did, though. So...
Thank you.
Kamsahamnida. Thank you very much. Now we're going to play a song called Andante Affettuoso. This song was originally written for the first movement of my second symphony, and I recorded the symphonies with the Prague Philharmonic, and it was a great experience. And I took those parts and turned them into a piano and cello duet. It says Andante Affettuoso.
Thank you.
Hunt. Okay, I have one more. All I have. I haven't played this song for 2 years, so bear with me, but I'm sure you know this song. Thank you.
네, 기대 이상으로 너무 아름다운 피아노 소리 때문에 너무 즐거운 시간이었고요. 브레이언 크레인에 대해서 원래 잘 알고 있었지만 직접 공연 와서 보니까 더 좋은 것 같습니다. 감사합니다.
잠시 눈을 감고 들어보니까 좀 바람과 숲과 그렇게 넓은 대지와 그런 것들을 눈을 감고 들으니까 더 깊이 느낄 수 있어서 너무 좋았습니다.
원래 브레이언 크레인 되게 좋아하는데 맨날 버터플라이 왈츠랑 소프라노 시나 쓰는데 너무 진짜 실제로 봐서 너무너무 감동적이었고